when the Supreme Court is supposed to have a quorum of at least five, and you can't get it. What does that tell you?
Well, that's the thing. You know, you can write all the laws you want. Kenya has one of the most progressive constitutions on the continent. In fact, some would say the world. And you can have laws, you can have process, you can put people in place and train them. But all the actors need to play well in the sandbox. You need to have, you know, people who are respecting the rules. You need to deal with this issue of corruption.
Yes.
We see in some of even in some of the observer reports for Liberia's elections, some of the poll workers probably needed a little bit more training, a little bit more time in those efforts. And those are things that the international community can help with, that Liberia can focus on for its next election. But then also the issue of impunity. And that's where this really comes in. When rules are made and they're broken without regard for
corruption
consequences.
And impunity.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And also, you know, the capacity of these institutions to enforce the law. So you have an electoral commission that cites violations. They need to have the teeth and the capacity to actually enforce.
To bite.
To bite. You need to bite.
So what happens to...
And the Kenyan Supreme Court bit.
What happens to people like, good people like, for example, Dr. Rosalind Akombe, a former, of course, commissioner of the IEBC, who at the end of the day says, you know what, I can't really continue to be part of this. And she leaves, she flies to New York. What happens to those types of people?
It's difficult. Listen, those commissions are under immense stress. There are a lot of politicians sticking their hands and trying to influence the process. It's a bit of a viper's nest in those commissions. And, you know, someone like Akombe, she's coming in, she has her UN experience, she has a good background. She thinks she's going to come in and be a technocrat. The problem is those positions are political in many ways. You need to have the skin, like Jega in Nigeria, to work your way through it.
He was a terrific guy.
Yeah, but he also had the same kind of pressure.
Yeah.
And he was facing corruption and he was dealing with issues head on. That's not just a technocrat or a lawyer, you know, and we've seen that in Ghana, we've seen it now in Liberia. These commissions really have to have some tough people, but also people who are going to have to be a part of this sort of political game, because that's what's happening there.
You know, I asked actually Akombe in a telephone conversation when she came back to the United States. I said, first of all, why did it take you so long? Secondly, how come you are the only person who has jumped ship? She said, you know what, to be very honest with you, there are others who think and feel like me, except that unlike me, they do not have another country to run or to go to.